The campaign for a second referendum on the outcome of any Brexit deal received a boost over the weekend. The co-founder of the clothing label Superdry made a record donation to the People's Vote campaign of £1 million. But Brexiteers dismissed the move, saying more people than ever want to leave the EU. Let's discuss all of this. We're joined by Femi Oluwole from Our Future, Our Choice and deputy editor at Brexit Central, David Scullion. Gentlemen, thank you for your time today. So both that intervention at the weekend from the owner of Superdry, big new poll from the anti-Brexit group Best for Britain, today a YouGov survey that says nearly 5,000 people that found that if a snap general election was held before Britain leaves the EU in March 2019, that Labour would lose great swathes of votes unless it abandoned its support for Brexit, which of course suggests that there is a movement towards wanting a people's vote. Femi, I'll start with you. Is it the way to go? And also, is there the time? Because we've got to get a deal quite soon.
Well, quite simply, the one thing that is actually finally uniting people is that nobody has any confidence in the way that we're going. A couple of months ago, it said that 11% of people thought that we were actually doing a good job with Brexit. And that was before the chief Brexit negotiator just quit the job. So the idea that this is going well is just not the case, because Our Future, Our Choice, we've been touring the country, going to leave areas, asking Brexit voters what they wanted: more sovereignty, better NHS, better off. And what's Brexit doing? Leaving us copying the rules of the EU without having a say. That means us less sovereign. It's depriving us of the doctors and nurses our NHS needs. That screws the NHS. And it leaves us cut off economically from our biggest, closest and cheapest trading partner. So that makes things more expensive. That makes us worse off. So if you want to fulfill the will of the 52%, Brexit, having a vote on the Brexit deal is the only democratic way forward.
OK, David, respond to Femi there. Some pretty strong points on those three points he's outlined pretty clearly.
You know, I think people have the right to chuck £1 million at a campaign, but let's call this what this is. This is an anti-democratic effort to thwart the will of the people, to thwart the first referendum. You know, I'm absolutely outraged about this because, you know, these people have faith in the single market, they've got faith in the customs union, they've got faith in EU law, but they don't have faith in the British people to have got it right. And what are they saying? They're saying, oh, the plebs have got it wrong, we need another vote. And we've seen countless times across the EU, we've seen France, we've seen Ireland, we've seen the Netherlands, we've seen Greece, where people's votes have been totally disregarded. They've been
But David,
to
what,
have
what Femi's saying there, what Femi is saying there, what Femi's saying, David, is that he's been to speak to people in Brexit voting areas who have brought up those three things. They don't think those three things are going to come back from a Brexit deal. So do you agree that those three things might not happen and therefore they should have another say on it, regardless of if they still want to leave the EU?
Well, the only thing that respects the referendum is to chuck checkers and is to take back control of our laws, our money and our borders. And, you know, it's not people's fault that Theresa May has mishandled these negotiations. It's not the people's fault that the civil service...
So surely they should have a say on the ultimate outcome.
No, because, you know, what this
The people
campaign,
shouldn't have
what,
a say.
What OFOC is angling for
that,
is
That seems fundamentally undemocratic.
Okay, Femi, let David answer your points there.
Look, I mean, everybody knows what's going on. These are Remainers, and it's still the Remain campaign. You know, you've got Open Britain, which was Britain Stronger in Europe, the BSE campaign, which is now the people's vote. It's the same people. They're making the same scare story arguments. And what the British people want is to take back control.
OK, Femi, simple, take back control.
Yeah, exactly. We should be taking back control. That means that we should actually be influencing the laws that we will ultimately be copying. I mean, right now, as an EU member, we have 73 of the 750 MEPs in the European Parliament. That means we have three times the voting weight of the average EU country. As far as having control, that's a pretty dominant position in Europe. What Theresa May is asking for is that we're going to be copying the rules of the EU, but we'd have given up our say. That makes us a less sovereign country. That means giving up control. Now, we actually have faith in the people. We think the people were absolutely right to demand real change in 2016, because we do not have a country that works for everybody. It works. We have a very London-centric Westminster.
So, Femi, if there was a people's vote and they were absolutely right to vote for change, the options on the table of no deal, Theresa May's deal, or staying in the EU, how does that create change that you think would be positive? Because I assume you think that no deal would not be positive. Staying in the EU is no change at all. And Theresa May's Chequers deal, again, I suppose, is something that you're not in favour of.
Well, as I'm saying, change is absolutely necessary. But for change to happen, for actual decent change to happen, you need investment in the north. You need investment in the areas of the country that need Westminster to actually give up something about them. Now, for that to happen, that needs money, time, resources. Whereas right now, the only thing the government seems to be bothered with is Brexit. And if Brexit goes ahead as planned, the only thing they'll be dealing with for the next 10, 20, 30 years is Brexit. Will they be fixing the NHS? No. Will they be fixing the housing crisis? No. Will they be fixing the broken electoral system? No. If you want things to get better in this country, the only thing we can do as a democracy is to have a say on a Brexit deal that has been completely fudged by the establishment.
OK, David, I want to ask you, and you as well, Femi, about, you know, the pretense for this discussion. Was the super dry owner getting involved, donating money to the People's Vote campaign? You say that you're completely against that, David. What about Nigel Farage getting back involved? He says that he might be up for getting back involved in politics, whether that's financial or not. You think that's a good thing, him getting involved, super dry owner, not so much?
Well, you know, if he's getting back involved in order to, you know, help deliver what was actually voted for, then absolutely I welcome that. You know, but all these arguments...
So if there's any money involved, you don't think it's a good thing?
No, I'm not saying that. All I'm saying is the head of Superdry is clearly too late to the party. All of these arguments were made before. He had the chance to donate his £1 million before. He had the chance, and as Femi had the chance, to make his arguments before the referendum. But now is not the time to do that. Look, this would be absolutely unprecedented to try and halt something which hasn't even been implemented yet. This is a democratic vote which is trying to be halted before it's even been decided. Can't these people wait 5-10 years when we're out of the EU and then make their positive case?
Femi, what do you think about Mr. Farage potentially making a political, in his words, comeback?
I'm just so glad he's back. I really am. Because, I mean, it means that we now have an opportunity to address everything that he said. I mean, one of the reasons why I'm sat here right now is because I got him to admit live on air that EU members can control immigration as long as and make sure that nobody can come here without a job unless they have sufficient resources not to become a burden and have comprehensive medical insurance, which goes directly against when he told us the EU forces us to let unlimited numbers of people come here, clog up the NHS and use our public services. So him coming back onto the front lines is just a godsend, to be honest.
I'd just like to finish with both of you a very quick question, yes or no answer if you can. Femi, you first. Do you think if there is a second vote, is it going to improve the relations between people in this country in terms of political, cultural divides?
I think that's necessary because right now we have you know the stats regarding age and how people voted, which means that right now, by 2021, we will have a population in this country that voted to remain. That means that, and that will get only worse with time, because as the demographic shifts even more. So that means that the people of this country will get increasingly poorer European, while the government is doing nothing but increasing Brexit. So that means that the divide in politics, between the politics and the people, is just going to get larger. Now, that will tear our country apart. That's not acceptable.
David, your thoughts. Will it bring people together or tear them apart, another vote?
Having a second referendum would be incredibly divisive and it would be democratically disastrous for this country.
OK. David, Femi, thank you both for spending the time with us today.
Cheers.
Thanks.